everyone. So I know it's been a while since I last posted a video, but that was because I had so many assignments and vivas that I couldn't get a day off. I had reminders for every single second that passed by, and I had reminders for every freaking thing happening in my life. And you know, at one point I actually had to put a reminder on my phone to remind myself to remember to breathe. But now I'm free. So here I am. And I've read quite a lot of novels during the time I wasn't posting, which you guys will get to know in the upcoming videos. So, as you guys know from the title of this video, that we are going to talk about a book which is so amazing that even though I'm done with it, I can't stop thinking about it. Actually, someone in the comments asked me to recommend a book which I absolutely love. Sorry couldn't tell you sooner, but it's Norwegian Wood by Murakami. Maybe you guys already saw this on my Instagram account, and I just said this so that I can say what I'm about to say, which is the link to my Instagram is mentioned in the description box below. So follow me there if you like, you know, just putting it out there. So back to the novel. So this novel is about a guy named Toru, and he is reliving the past events of his life. He talks about people who had been an important part of his life, like Naomi, Kizuki, Stormtrooper, Nagasawa, Midori and all. And what's best about all these characters is that most of them have these amazing backstories. When you read this novel, you'll actually feel yourself connect with all these characters. Brilliant characterization. I mean, every character felt so freaking real. You know, there's this amazing thing with every character that you can actually differentiate every character's characteristic. And in English, that means that all the characters are very well constructed. There is depth in their individual personalities, which is why after reading this novel, you will remember each character with their own sets of personality traits. Now, the second most striking thing of Norwegian Wood is that Murakami writes in such a beautiful flow that you won't be able to stop yourself from reading further. This novel is a little lengthy, but trust me, once you start reading it, you won't be able to get enough of it. So what I'm trying to say is that the novel Norwegian Wood is basically if addiction had a face. It's so goddamn addictive. You can actually feel yourself connect to every word of this novel. And I gotta tell you, not a lot of novels have the potential to do this. And check this out. Blackish grime and bits of indefinable matter clung to all the bowls and dishes on the shelves. And the floors were littered with instant ramen wrappers and empty beer cans and discarded lids from one thing or another. It never occurred to anyone to sweep up and throw these things in the bin. Any wind that blew through would raise clouds of dust. Each room had its own horrendous smell, but the components of that smell were always the same: sweat, body odor, and rubbish. Dirty clothes would pile up under the beds, and without anyone bothering to the air and the mattresses on a regular basis. These sweat-impregnated pads would give off odors beyond redemption. In retrospect, it seems amazing that these shit piles gave rise to no-killer epidemics. So, you see what I'm talking about? And this brings me to my next point, which is Murakami's observation skills. The reason why Murakami is able to retain the attention of the readers is because he is an incredibly observant person. Like when he wrote about Toru's day-to-day routine, there I saw that how keenly he had observed all those boring routines that we follow every day. And this is something which I'm trying to look for in every single novel that I'm reading these days. Which is something I definitely shouldn't do, because we should never compare two different writers to one another. And that's why I'm bummed about the fact that I can't find a single novel which is as explicit as this one. And after having heard a lot about Murakami's style of writing, I've come to the conclusion that Murakami novels fall under an entirely different genre of their own. And this is something I'm gonna explain to you in a little while. Check out Murakami's observation skills. Now, I could step into a whole new swamp. And it was time for exams. And these I passed with relative ease. If you have nothing else to do and spend all your time going to lectures, it takes no special skills to get through end of year exams. So I just love how simple this paragraph is, and it shows how normal and boring our lives are. Now the next thing is that this book is translated by Jay Rubin, and I think even he deserves a great amount of praise because he has translated this novel beautifully. So if you're stressed and you like books which deal with handling grief, pain, heartbreak, relationships, friendships, you should definitely check this novel out. Because in short, Murakami knows his shit. Besides, this book is all about choosing between the past or the future. So this is something that we all struggle with. Which is why I think that this book is really going to help anyone who finds himself or herself stuck in this kind of situation right now. And now I'll come to the final point, which is that I will rate this book 4.5 stars out of 5 stars because I was highly creeped out with some of the scenes and characters of this novel. So there were some segments which were like,
oh, my eyes!
The main problem was that I read it and after that I couldn't unread it. So I was traumatized. I mean, what the hell? See, I have heard that Murakami crosses conventional boundaries, but I couldn't exactly understand why does the whole scene needs to be gross?
Why would you do that?
Because I was like, yeah, sure, go ahead, think outside the box, but don't do that. So I'll narrate the scene to you because I don't want to be the only one who's going to have a scarred soul now. So the scene was this. This one girl character is lamenting her father's death. So she strips herself naked and sits in front of her father's picture and says, "Do you like what you created, father?" And to be honest, if I were her father, I'd say no. Because who does that? So I was like, "Ye kya hai? Iski to koi zarurat nahi thi." And after this, I was like, okay, so Murakami, you want your audience to think about getting rid of their mental blocks. Cool, superb, great idea. You don't have to creep your readers out for that. So I'm not going to go into detail about the scene. You can read it yourself if you want. I don't know why anyone would want it. So yeah, you get it. I want to forget this so bad because after reading this, I was thinking about Murakami and I was like, dude, you're sick. So I got the message, but it was so freaking disgusting to read something like that.
Do that.
Also, I kept thinking that I'm the reader, so I see why I can't unread it. But Murakami knew what he was doing, and he revised this novel, edited it, and still thought that this scene was worth keeping in the novel. But you know, being a little creepy is Murakami's thing, I guess. Hello everyone, how have you been doing? Hope you are well. So about Norwegian Wood, I think it's a very explicit novel. And Murakami focuses more on showing the audience rather than telling them the story, which makes this novel brilliant. You will see yourself in most of the characters. And the most amazing thing about this novel is its theme. Drew finds himself stuck between his past self and future self. So, the way that struggle is expressed by Murakami is amazing. Everything is great except for the scene that I narrated. After that scene, I wanted to put this book in the freezer. There are more strange scenes, but that one scarred my thinking for life. So, what you should do to avoid this, that when you feel that you know where the story is going, then just skip a few pages and you'll be good to go. The thing is that that's Murakami's style. Like I said, Murakami novels fall under an entirely different genre of their own. So, you will find yourself stuck in this love-hate relationship with these novels. Of course, I do not like that part of his style, but that doesn't diminish the fact that Murakami is great with words. He gets a little creepy at times, but still, I will recommend you to read this novel yourself because this is a very well-written novel and it's very soothing. Like I said, Murakami novels fall under an entirely different genre of their own. Now, I know that some of you will think that this novel is not perfect, but it's almost perfect. And that, according to my definition, is perfect. Majority of the novel is great except for a few segments where Murakami is being Murakami, but that's just my opinion. You guys are free to share your opinions about this novel or any other novel of his, or you can tell me whether you're going to read this novel or whether you're going to subscribe to this channel or like this video. You see how smoothly I turned it around? But seriously, I don't care if you're going to throw your current read on the subscribe button or your coffee mug, but subscribe button dab jana chahiye. And also, don't forget to like and comment on this video. Yes, go ahead. It only takes a minute and it'll make me happy. So what do you have to lose? I'll see you all next Monday.